referee is Antonio Mateu Laos from Valencia in Spain, strongly criticised by Pep Guardiola. Nigeria-Argentina match. Well, three changes. No place for Kari Arneson, instead Sverri Ingason, who plays his club football for the local team, FC Rostov, lines up alongside his Rostov partner, Ragnar Sigurdsson. Johan Per Gudmundsson has recovered from injury. He plays, as does Emil Hallfredsson. Out go Gislason and Budvarsson, Ali.
Yeah, and they're returning to the system that they used in that qualifier where they were able to get the result over Croatia, going to that 4-5-1 and bringing in the defensive-minded Halvorsen-Gunnarsson partnership.
For Croatia, nine changes from the side that took down Argentina. It's perhaps easier to tell you who has been retained, namely Luka Modric and Ivan Perisic. The only player carrying a yellow card yet still included is Vedran Čoluka.
And I think some people would be surprised that Modric is getting the nod today. It'll be interesting to see if he does play in a deeper role or higher up on the pitch. He's occupied both in the previous two matches. But it'll be battle to be the one will be more likely the linchpin and allow the freedom for Modric and Kovacic to roam about, find the game, and try to break down this incredibly...
Countdown. And now the action. Iceland forced onto the defensive again. And was there contact there? Just a... Yevai. What a confidence. Kamaric making the run through the centre. Perisic. Linking the play beautifully, and the result was going wide off the boot of Perisic. Gunnarsson not to get Davis. Kicked in there by Bjarnason, and again. And here is Sigurdsson. Options inside the area, including Finn Bogason. What do they have in store for Croatia here at Iceland? Sigurdsson stinging the pass. Johan Per Gudmundsson and Magnusson. Not again. And look at Modric. That's what you'd like to forget all about. And well, Kalinic was struggling. Bjarnason
comes out through traffic but doesn't make a strong play on it. Oh, looks like he gets a fantastic second save though.
Credit to him at the second time of asking for certain there.
And he gets the help, it looks like.
Open Bogason. And winning it by fair means. He has a back. They held their breath, the Iceland fans.
And you've done the dirty work. He's the player who wins it. Croatia's just trying to play out of pressure, and Battle just gets caught on it. And then the quick combination.
Bardet, what about the shot? Finally does shoot. And off the top of the crossbar, off the boot of Milan Bardet.
Just in the last couple minutes, you're seeing a little more initiative from Croatia in this situation. Battle's just drifting in space. No one steps to him. He gets the deflection, in fact, off of Ragnar Sigurdsson. Nods it off the top.
And it comes this time. And trouble there, potentially, for Croatia. Oh, it's an excellent save by Kalinic as he foils Ingason.
And again, he just gets caught. He's trying to come out to make a play on that initial ball. Doesn't get anywhere clear near it.
Pivanic, crossful play from the left back, Badel for Croatia. Iceland come unstuck, and the man who struck the woodwork just seconds ago has this time found the back of the net. Joy for Croatia, but Iceland's World Cup dreams may well be in tatters.
And it was with an overload. Modric switches play here, finds Battle, they get it back.
Gylfi Sigurdsson for Iceland. Oh, it just wouldn't go in for Ingason again. Thunder in the stands, lightning on the pitch. Badel, fine piece of ball winning. And for all. And Croatia back on course for a 100% group stage.
Well, you can't blame Iceland. They had to leave themselves exposed. They've been running and running and running and trying to make something here, playing out of the back. They just get picked early in that offensive.